Hello. I want to talk about a problem that we often see in any kind of automation, but today it's going to be specifically around SAP. So when you are working on automating a robot, or you created a workflow that automates something inside an application, and at some point you end up in a different place than what is normally the starting point. So, for instance, I have a simple workflow here. It opens Excel, it clears all the lines, it then gets the menu, and it then adds all the items in the menu into Excel. It's just an example. So, this works, right? But if I go to a different area inside SAP, and run the workflow, it now fails, right? It tells me it can't find that specific element. So, I could check for this, right? I could check it and I could throw a more meaningful error than item not found. I could kill SAP and start it from scratch to make sure that I'm where I want to be. And depending on applications, that might make sense. But regarding SAP, we have another option. So this menu up here is, or text field, or whatever you want to call it, is super cool, right? It allows us to quickly jump to whatever place inside SAP that we want. And the main screen, the main thing that we see, we can easily get to. So a common way of setting up your automation is that you have a preparing workflow that set up the interface the way that you want it. So I created a workflow here called Go to Main, and Go to Main will do that, right? So if I'm a different place here and I set a breakpoint, if I run this, it will then go to the main menu. So now my automation will work. So if I continue, I get my main items, right? I can go wherever I want, and whatever I do, if I run the workflow, it will go to where it should be, and I get the result that I expected. This is also where I can do stuff like checking whether I'm logged in or the application is actually working. So if we go to that specific workflow, so if I close SAP and completely close it, what you will see is I set up a system name, I get a username and password as a credential inside OpenFlow, so they're not stored inside the workflow in clear text. I then call the activity called login. So login will take my username and password. No, actually, login will look at the system name and it will compare the system name with the active session that is actually going on. If no session is on, it will simply start SAP and do the logon process. If the system name does, if there is a connection active but the system name doesn't match, it will then start a new session and log in with the credentials that we gave it. So if I set a breakpoint here, you will see that it actually runs SAP and it then logs in. If I stop it, I don't have another SAP to log into, so I can't show that, but doesn't really matter. The next thing it does is that it checks whether we are actually on the getting started page or the main page. And if we are not, it then goes up to the to this field up here, and it tells it to go to the main page. The problem with that is that sometimes going to the main page, can I trick this somehow? No, I'm not sure how to trick it, but sometimes going to that specific page means that you just get a blank page with a button that says start SAP Easy Access. And I've seen two variations of that. There's probably more, but these are the two versions that I've seen. I check for that button, and if that button is there, I then actually click that button to make sure that I am at a good starting point. Maybe I don't want to go to the main menu. Maybe I'll just jump to, you know, whatever page that I want. I could just type that here and jump directly to it. But again, depends on the case. In this case, I like to have a way to quickly close all windows and go to the main page, make sure that I'm logged in, and then everything just works. And by putting that in a separate workflow, I can then put that at the top of all my workflows, and it will then take care of everything for me. Just a little hint. I hope it helps you. Yeah.